guys, what's up? This is Blaze the Movie Fan, and it's time for another commentary video. This time I will be commentating on Berg Productions. The name might sound familiar, and that's because it is. Back in 2016, he made many horrible rants on the commentary community. But you know what? I don't hold that against him. These videos were made a long time ago and he is already over the drama. Today I will be commenting on a more recent video that he made. And that is his video on That Kid Douglas. Now I have seen a lot of videos on That Kid Douglas. And there were two that were absolutely terrible. They are videos by Clay Claymore and Jesse Bissy. I have commented on both of these horrible videos. Today, I will be covering a video on That Kid Douglas that's actually good. Now, this video is not perfect. In fact, there are some issues that I have with it. But as this is a good video overall, I will, for the most part, be expanding on Borg's points rather than arguing with them. So, anyway, without further ado, let's dive in.
I must say, the first episode of this series was a success because Autonomous Alice went back to her roots as a blogger. If you haven't seen her content, I suggest you see it after this video is over. It's a gold mine of entertainment.
That's interesting, I might check her out later. You know what? Fuck it, I trust you that she is a good YouTuber. So you know what? I decided to subscribe to her. And done! I am now subscribed to her. I hope I won't regret it. I probably won't, since you have good reasons to recommend her, I'm sure.
That Kid Douglas is known for multiple content. Young Hero Rants, Young Hero Speaks, The Guide to Surviving the Internet, and Dumb Moments in YouTube History.
My personal favorite series of his is his Examining series, where he analyzes bad YouTubers and goes into full detail as to why they suck, as well as reveal some of the scummy things that they've done. He puts a lot of effort into those series and it shows. The fact that he puts so much research into his series is the main reason why it's so fucking awesome.
His first video was on March 29th, 2008 of some Pokemon game on some random handheld. Obviously this was nothing to be proud of, but Douglas had to start somewhere.
How is recording yourself playing a Pokemon game nothing to be proud of? Are you implying that there's something wrong with liking Pokemon? If so, I can tell you that you are completely wrong. I am subscribed to a lot of Pokemon fans on YouTube, and most of them are very mature people, as well as very smart individuals. So there is absolutely nothing wrong with a grown man liking Pokemon. Now I am of course aware of the possibility that's not what you meant at all. And if that's not what you meant, I apologize for what I said earlier. If it's not what you meant, what exactly did you mean? Because I'm confused.
One of that Kid Douglas's most controversial Young Hero rants was on a nigger named Clay Claymore. Someone that said Spurg is an insult and got angry when people called him out on his attitude. Clay Claymore had an ego the size of China. While Douglas did have good points, Clay sometimes exaggerated his points for the lulz. This still does not excuse Clay Claymore for the deplorable things he did, which can be read on Encyclopedia Dramatica.
I used to hate Clay Claymore's videos, but over time I have learned to appreciate them. And to be honest, I like most of Clay Claymore's videos. But there is one thing that hasn't changed about me since 2016. I still hate Clay Claymore as a person. And That Kid Douglas did a great job explaining all the problems with him. I mean seriously, fuck Clay Claymore, he is a terrible person. Oh, and by the way, I don't buy for a minute that he is a troll. I really think that he is legit.
Whether you like That Kid Douglas or not, you gotta give him credit for one thing. He always has the receipts for whatever he is talking about.
What? I did catch most of the words that you were trying to say, but there is one word that I didn't quite catch. And I have replayed this clip multiple times. He always gets receipts of whatever he's talking about. Now, even though I didn't catch all the words that you were saying, I do think I get what you were trying to say. You probably mean that he knows what he's talking about most of the times. And if that's so, you're absolutely right.
Sure. People can criticize That Kid Douglas for his low production value, which is a cliched complaint. Reading a script on camera, or act like a jackrabbit on occasions.
To be honest with you, I think those are very nitpicky points. I've watched that kid Douglas many times. Not at one point do I find his camera presence distracting. In my personal opinion, you can only find his camera presence distracting if you're looking for problems.
But in comparison to other Canadian users like Ponder Sprocket, Alexander Bader, Barrio Teplumber, and Jerry Pete, that kid Douglas seems to be a rational Canadian that has his head on straight.
I'm sorry, but I think comparing that kid Douglas with the Game Dude is a very unfair comparison. The Game Dude was a fucking dumbass who couldn't make a good game review to save his life. I mean, seriously, it's obvious that he put no effort into his terrible game reviews at all. Oh, and at the top of that, he also wasted people's times by re-uploading remade versions of his reviews, which were mostly the same, except worse. Speaking of the Game Dude, why the hell are you even bringing him up in the first place? He hasn't been relevant in years! Now I understand bringing up irrelevant users when talking about YouTube history, but you aren't even doing that here, so this comes across as pointless to me. Wouldn't it make more sense to name someone from Canada which people still care about? Speaking of irrelevant dead subjects, Mario the Plumber is also a dead subject. And he fits the definition of a dead subject far more than Game Dude does. While people have brought something new to the table about the Game Dude for the last year or so, nobody has brought anything new to the table about Mario the Plumber.
To conclude this video, I want to say this. While I am a racist person, I still gotta give respect to that kid Douglas for telling the truth in an unbiased fashion.
Alright, let me ask you a legitimate question. Why would you admit in a public video that you are racist? I mean seriously, why the hell would you do that? Being racist is nothing to be proud of. That is the main reason why most people don't admit that they are racist and are trying to avoid being racist. Judging people by something that they can't help is very scummy. Now I'm aware that some people in the comment section might point out that this was a joke. And I can tell you for a fact that no, it isn't. How do I know this? Because he has admitted in one of his videos that most of his videos are serious.
With the oversaturation of humor on the internet, which 90% of it is not organic, this justifies me making content in a very serious demeanor.
Now it's time for my overall thoughts. This is, in my opinion, the best video on that kid Douglas. With so many rants talking about how horrible he is, it sure is a breath of fresh air to see a video on that kid Douglas that's actually positive. Oh, and one last thing that I must give Burry Productions credit for. He has come a long way since 2016. So Burry Productions, if you are watching this video, keep up the good work, man. I really like your videos. Well guys, here is the end of the video. Thank you for watching, have a great day.